Hey everyone, today we are talking all about constipation and what to do about it when it comes to your babies and your toddlers. Hi guys, it's Renee with New Ways Nutrition, and today we're talking about constipation. Now this is one of the most frequent things I hear as a worry from parents, and it's really wondering what to do about it and what foods can help with it. So first and foremost, let's talk about what we're actually referring to when it comes to constipation. So know that as your baby starts solid food, or as your toddler changes their eating habits and their movement and all of that, then their bowel movements are going to change. We are not looking at the number of days in between a bowel movement. We are looking at some symptoms that go along with it. So just because your baby or your toddler goes a couple of days in between stools, it does not mean that they are constipated, first and foremost. Really what we're looking for from a symptom standpoint is hard pellet-like stools, pain or blood with bowel movements, or really excessive straining when they're trying to go. So that is what is going to signal constipation. And it can happen when your child has gone every day, and it can happen when your child only goes once every 4 days. So just keep that in mind. Symptoms are what we're looking at here, not number of days between bowel movements. So with that being said, there are a couple of things to keep in mind. Any dietitian is going to tell you that the number one thing that you want to be thinking about is fiber, fluid, and movement. So we're talking fiber from fruits and veggies and whole grains. So you want to make sure that you're offering a variety of those in their diet. There is no magic food that is going to all of a sudden make them have more regular or easy bowel movements. There are a couple of foods that you can try, and we'll get into those in a minute, but just know that it's the overall balance of fiber in their diet from those fruits, veggies, and whole grains. You're also you want to look at hydration. So this is a little bit different when it comes to toddlers and babies. With babies, the hydration really comes from their breast milk or their formula. So you don't need to worry as much about this. We really don't want to be overloading them with water. So focus on breast milk and formula for under one. For over one, you do want to be focusing, making sure that you're offering water at snack times and at meals and between if they need it. So just make sure that they have easy access to water that you're offering. Don't force them to drink it. Don't make a big deal about it, but make sure that you're offering them lots of opportunities to drink that water. And then movement. Again, not something that's quite as applicable to babies, but with toddlers, it can definitely help. Make sure they're getting active. Make sure that they're moving throughout the day, and that can help their bowels to move everything through. With babies especially, you can do some bowel massage, some tummy massage with that, and there are some other resources online that you can find on how to do that, and your pediatrician can also advise you on that. But that would be a little bit more on the baby side of things. So remember, fiber, fluid, and movement is what we are really looking for. And then when it comes to toddlers, also keep in mind that a lot of times, if your toddler starts to develop some form of constipation, the root of that can be a traumatic or scary experience. So something as simple as your toddler is learning how to use the toilet and they're scared to go poop on the toilet. That can cause them to hold it in, and then that can really just compound itself and cause it to get worse and worse and worse. So as to the best of your ability, you want to try and address the root problem more than fixing the kind of a band-aid solution. So try and get to the root of whatever you think that the problem might be, and that will have much more of an effect oftentimes than trying it from the other side of things. So what foods can we actually use to help? Like I said, there are no magic ones. The common ones that people know about are the pea fruits. So think pears, peaches, plums, and prunes. But there are a couple other foods that you can try to help keep your child regular or to help once constipation has set in. So those things are like apple juice, coconut oil, flax seeds, chia seeds, kiwi fruit, sweet potatoes, and kefir. So those are the ones that are kind of in the literature, for what literature there is. Those are the ones that show that they are somewhat beneficial. So with that, also keep in mind that every child is going to be different. Those foods might work for some kids. They're not going to work for a lot of kids, to be honest. And there's a lot of other foods that will also help. Fruits and veggies have all sorts of beneficial things to them. So I know that cherry tomatoes seem to work for my daughter, on top of a couple other on the list that I mentioned. So know that lots of different fruits and vegetables and whole grains can help to keep your child regular. And especially starting from the beginning, just focus on a wide variety in the diet, and that can help to make sure that you're offering enough fiber to help them remain regular and prevent constipation. And last but not least, don't be afraid to talk to your doctor when it comes to constipation. Solving it earlier and not letting it go on can help your child to have normal bowel movements as they grow older. The more and more it gets compounded, the harder it can be for them to return to normal bowel movements. So make sure, if you're concerned and you have any, if your child has any of those symptoms that I talked about, so remember, hard pellet-like stools, pain or blood with bowel movements, or excessive straining, that's when you want to be talking to your doctor if that goes on for any length of time. So make sure you bring up your concerns with them and work on it with them too. All right, I hope that helped, and have a good day.